again, Romualdez, this is for Romualdez, this is not his first time as House Speaker. He was House Speaker before in 2019, and now he is again being sworn in as House Speaker. Let's listen in.
Having been elected Speaker of the House of Representatives,
having been elected Speaker of the House of Representatives,
hereby solemnly swear,
hereby solemnly swear,
that I will well and faithfully discharge,
I will well and faithfully discharge,
to the best of my ability,
to the best of my abilities,
the duties of my present position,
the duties of my present position,
and of all others,
and of all others,
I may hereafter hold,
I may hereafter hold,
under the Republic of the Philippines,
under the Republic of the Philippines,
that I will support and defend,
that I shall support and defend,
the Constitution of the Philippines,
the Constitution of the Philippines,
that I will bear true faith,
that I will bear true faith,
and allegiance,
and allegiance,
to the same,
to the same,
and that I will obey the laws and legal orders,
and that I'll obey the laws and legal orders,
and decrees promulgated,
and the decrees promulgated,
by the duly constituted authorities,
by the duly constituted authorities,
of the Republic of the Philippines,
of the Republic of the Philippines,
and that I impose this obligation,
and that I impose this obligation,
upon myself voluntarily,
upon myself voluntarily,
without mental reservation,
without mental reservation,
or purpose of evasion,
or purpose of evasion,
so help me God,
so help me God.
Congratulations.
There you have it. Leyte Representative Martin Romualdez assumes the House Speakership for a second time since 2019 when he relinquished the role. Behind him, of course, Vice President Sara Duterte Carpio in her native Bagobo, where, and his family, of course. So, Romualdez is a paternal aunt, is actually former First Lady Imelda Romualdez Marcos. And this makes Ferdinand Marcos Sr., his uncle, and Bongbong and Senator Aimee Marcos, his cousins. Quick picture right there for the family. Okay, Romualdez is the president of the Lakas CMD party, but perceived to be the strongest political party right now in the House of Congress or House of Representatives. Most of the parties at the House have also declared their support for the House Speakership of Romualdez. But among those who abstained from voting for Romualdez had been Gabriela Party List Representative Arlene Brosas and ACT Teachers Party List Representative Franz Castro. Romualdez had earlier said the biggest challenge that the incoming administration will face is reducing poverty through the attainment, and he plans to address that through legislation that will help attain inclusive growth. And we are waiting for his acceptance speech. Now, just 2 weeks ago, Romualdez had filed the bill previously passed by the House of Representatives seeking to create a United States-type Center for Disease Control and Prevention, a medical facility that would better prepare the country for future pandemics. And we are waiting for more direction and possibly hear what he would like the new 19th Congress, or rather the 19th Congress, to take on as priority bills in the coming months.
May I request our colleagues in the House to kindly sit down.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It is the afternoon already, so I shall not tarry. The ladies and gentlemen, the members of the House of Representatives of the 19th Congress, I'd like very much to extend my thanks, first of all, to the President of the Republic of the Philippines, Ferdinand Bongbong Romualdez Marcos Jr., for having espoused the message of unity and for supporting the House of Representatives, its leadership, and the legislative agenda that we shall forge ahead. I'm deeply grateful for the presence of the Vice President and Secretary of Education, Inday Sara Duterte. Salamat. I, of course, would like to extend my thanks to my family, my mother who is here, thank you so much, and the rest of my family, my brother, my sister-in-law, my children. Thank you for the support and the sacrifices, and of course, mostly to my wife, Congresswoman Yeda. You're my inspiration. But most of all, of course, to all our friends here who've made it very, very possible for me to be up here. I'd like to, of course, thank my immediate past predecessor, Speaker Lord Alan J. Velasco. Beyond the legislative agenda that we had accomplished together, he's too responsible for the refurbishment and the most beautiful session hall that we have today. So thank you, Speaker, and of course to our Secretary General and the staff who've gotten this all together. I'd like to also thank one and all for your unequivocal support for our leadership for the 19th Congress. Rather than I accept the position, I ask you all to accept the duty of service to the people. For you and I can do this all together as a team, as we had in the previous Congress. And in unity, as they say, there is strength. I'm deeply elated beyond words for the trust and confidence you've reposed upon me. You, my distinguished members of the chamber, your unqualified support has overwhelmed me. And it is with high hopes that together we shall hurdle the challenges that we face at this stage of the COVID-19 pandemic. We are entering the endemic stages, and we are confident that with the unity that our president has espoused, we can actually overcome the crippling effects of this pandemic and, of course, the political differences that occurred in the recent elections, as well as the global impacts such as the Ukrainian war. The tasks ahead of us may seemingly be daunting, but our synergy is the seed that will nurture us for the ensuing years. We will work together to ensure that the House of Representatives truly embodies the will of the people. We will work hand in hand to ensure the swift passage of House measures that are needed by the people and would support development across all sectors of society at different levels of government, and with unity of purpose, there is nothing that we cannot do. As your Speaker, I vow to attend to all the concerns of your constituents. I shall try to be as fair as possible and to favor no one. There will be a fair and equitable distribution of resources for the development of our regions, regardless of political affiliations. Every Filipino family must be included in any developmental agenda. No one gets left behind. I will keep my office always open, available to all, always open to you, the members of the House, for we are the House of the people, the majority and the minority. Priority will be given to those willing to share their aspirations with all their constituents with me. And thank you, my dear colleagues, for the honor, for choosing me to serve as your Speaker of the House of Representatives for the 19th Congress. I gladly accept your trust and confidence with a promise that we will collectively work to make the 19th Congress the best it can possibly be. Mabuhay pa kayong lahat. Mabuhay ang Pilipino.
Mr. Speaker, I move for the adoption of the 18th Congress Rules of the House of Representatives as amended.
And we just saw the new House Speaker, late Representative Martin Romualdez. He takes over for the 18th Congress Speaker, Lord Alan Velasco. And consistent with the new administration's battle cry, Romualdez called for unity.
The rules of the 18th Congress as amended is hereby adopted as provisional rules for the House of Representatives for the 19th Congress.
As they build legislation that will address the economic impact of the pandemic. A congressman several times over and a former majority leader, Romualdez is believed to be a consensus builder among the legislators.
Raise your right hand and repeat after me. I state your name. Of having been elected to the position of representative, hereby solemnly swear that I will faithfully discharge to the best of my abilities the duties of my present position and all others that I may hold hereafter under the Republic of the Philippines, that I will support and defend the Constitution of the Philippines, that I will bear true faith and allegiance to the same, that I will obey the laws, legal orders, and decrees promulgated by the duly constituted authorities of the Republic of the Philippines. And that I impose this obligation upon myself voluntarily, without mental reservation or purpose of evasion. So help me God. Congratulations. Welcome to the 19th Congress.
Mr. Speaker, I move that we now proceed to the election of the deputy speakers.
And right there again, House Speaker Martin Romualdez leading the swearing in and oath taking of the new congressman to the 19th Congress. Romualdez enjoys the support of most of the major political parties of the House of Representatives, including his own Lakas CMD, of which he is president and which now has 64 congressmen. Other parties supporting him are Duterte's PDP Laban, the National Unity Party, Nationalista Party, Nationalist People's Coalition, and the Partyless Coalition. Former President and Pampanga Representative Gloria Macapagal-Arroyo had also thrown her support for Romualdez, despite reports she herself was eyeing the speakership. Arroyo already served as Speaker under the former President Duterte from 2018 to 2019. Arroyo had rallied support for Romualdez's bid for the speakership in the 18th Congress, but he became majority leader after then-President Rodrigo Duterte brokered a term-sharing agreement between then-Representative Alan Peter Cayetano and Lord Alan Velasco. And we'll bring you more of the latest developments out of the Batasang Pambansa in the coming hours for our continuing coverage of President Marcos's first State of the Nation address. I'm Rain Musngi. Stay on ANC.